I want to tell you two really cool stories that really kind of illustrate what self-sacrifice looks like. You are a winner, and I believe that you can be a better man today than you were yesterday. Hey, I want to talk to you today about this idea of self-sacrifice. I want to tell you two really cool stories that really kind of illustrate what self-sacrifice looks like. The first story I want to tell you is about a movie I saw the other day that might be in my top three movies now of all times. It's the movie Hacksaw Ridge. It's a very gory movie, so let me give you a little explicit content warning there. It's not a movie you want to watch with your kids, but it's a movie that's so valuable, I think every man needs to see. So this true story was about a man named Desmond Doss. And Desmond lived at the time of World War II, and he wanted to fight for his country. He believed that it was a righteous cause that the Americans were fighting for. But the thing about Desmond was he wasn't going to pick up a gun. He had made a vow to God that he wasn't going to shoot anyone or he wasn't going to fight in the war, but he wanted to serve. He wanted to serve as a medic. And so in the story, the army tries to kind of kick him out of the army. They don't really want him because he's not willing to hold a gun, but he, through a lot of trials, makes it to the war. And when he gets to the war, he has to fight in one of the most bloody battles there is of the war, the Battle of Hacksaw Ridge. And so they were fighting the Japanese, and Desmond went as a medic, so he didn't have a gun, and he put his life on the line to help save those who were injured. And so the scene goes, the Americans had got beaten back, there were thousands of men who had been killed, and everyone has kind of gone down this large ridge, Hacksaw Ridge, down on ropes, and Desmond's kind of the only one left up on the hill. And so he's kind of exhausted. He says, "God, I can't hear your voice." And then he hears a soldier cry for help. And he says, "Okay, Lord, I hear you." And so he goes to help that soldier. And then he goes to help another soldier. And then another soldier. And every time he comes back, he says, "Give me one more, Lord. Give me the strength to get one more." But Desmond Doss that night pulled over 75 men to safety from that ridge. And so he was a hero. He was given the Medal of Honor. And so he was one of a very highly decorated hero, and he never used a gun. But it was a picture of self-sacrifice, that he was willing to give his life to try to save the lives of others. And that is a picture of heroism. Real men seek responsibility. We seek to step in when others step out. This is what Jesus did. The Bible says, Jesus said, "I did not come to be served, but to serve and to give his life as a ransom for many." So Jesus was the ultimate picture of self-sacrifice. But you know, there's the Hollywood self-sacrifice. There's these great stories of self-sacrifice. But what does that look like for a man every single day? What does it mean to be self-sacrificing? Well, I can think of a few things. One, men, one way just to be self-sacrificing in a real simple way is always eat last. At your home, at your family, if people are around, always eat last. It just says, "I'm not going to put myself before my family." If you see anyone out in public, or if you see even a family member, one of your children, mistreating someone, you step in when you see someone mistreated. You don't walk the other way. You put yourself in harm's way in order to help someone that might be in need. That's self-sacrifice. Another form of self-sacrifice is just being willing to speak hard truths. Sometimes people skirt around the issue of truth. You see, when you really love somebody, you're willing to tell them the truth in love. That doesn't mean you try to beat them over the head with the truth, but it means that you take the time to walk someone through what's going on in their life in a way that might be meaningful. That's self-sacrifice. Self-sacrifice means you're not a lazy man. Self-sacrifice means that you get up and you're disciplined and you do the things you need to do because you're serving your family. Little things, little acts of self-sacrifice are seen every day in your marriage and in your parenting. It might be a little thing like you go to the movie that she wants to see instead of the one you want to see, or you go to the restaurant that she likes to go to instead of the restaurant that you like to go to. Or maybe you have that list of things that you want to get done, but you say, you know what, honey, I'd rather do the list that you have for me instead of the list that I'm thinking I might want to get done. Self-sacrifice means that you take the time to listen to your children when there's things going on in their lives, that you put down those things that might be important to you in order to help them. So I want to tell you about a young man, a really awesome story named Bridger Walker. He's 6 years old, and his story has just fascinated me. I think it's an amazing story, and so I want to tell you about it. Here's the story. 6-year-old Bridger Walker has proven that not all heroes wear capes. After he threw himself between a charging dog and his little sister, the news of Bridger's bravery has drawn reactions from people all around the world. On July 9th, 6-year-old Bridger Walker ran to save his sister, standing between her and a charging dog. The boy received 90 stitches, but is now home and recovering. He is a true hero and a fantastic older brother. After getting bitten several times on his face and head, Bridger Walker grabbed his sister's hand and ran with her to keep her safe. He said, "If someone had to die, I thought it should be me." Bridger's bravery has drawn reactions from many different celebrities. So this young man, I love his quote. He says, "If someone had to die, I thought it should be me." Men, the picture of self-sacrifice is that if someone has to die, if someone has to suffer, it should be me. And that is what Jesus Christ did for us on the cross. Instead of making us pay for our sins, a debt that we could not pay, Jesus laid down his life for us. And so I encourage you, men, be a man who is a man of self-sacrifice. Be like Desmond Doss. Be like Bridger. Be a man that stands in the gap for other men and for your family.